Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how I performed cosmetic surgery on my Asian arowana. This is going to be a relatively longer video because I want to show you everything that I did and take you through a step by step. Now, cosmetic surgery on aquarium fish is relatively more common than you might think. A lot of you are probably concerned with the fact that it stresses the fish out and or it's hurting it. And I wanted to talk about that first. First of all, the fish is going to be completely sedated, knocked out. It's not going to feel a thing. The only thing it's going to remember is it being netted. And chances are it's probably not even going to remember that. I net the fish, I put it into a container of medicated water, and within a few seconds, it's knocked out. So obviously it's not going to be stressed and or it's not going to feel any pain. However, when it comes to the fish's fins, some say that they feel pain, others say they do not. From what I understand, there are no nerve endings in the actual fins unless you get into the fleshy part, and without nerve endings, you don't feel anything. So why do it in the first place? This is a feature fish for me, meaning that it's a showcase fish. It's the only fish in this aquarium, and I'm keeping the fish based on its appearance. The entire focus of the aquarium is the fish, and this fish is going to live for the next 15, 20, 25 years. So of course I would want it to look the best it possibly could. And if I can influence that in any way, I most certainly will. We all want our fish to look their best. Especially when you have a $2,000 fish swimming around in your tank, you do want it to look good. So when it came to my Asian arowana, it appeared as though his body continued to grow, but his fins did not. So I decided that if I trimmed them off, I would reset them and give them a chance to grow out properly. So this is how I did it. Now to sedate the fish, I'm using clove oil. Now when clove oil is mixed with water, it will have a sedative effect on your fish, meaning it's going to knock the fish out. Now one of the benefits to clove oil is it's actually very commonly available, it's cheap, and it's very difficult to overdose your fish on it. So if you use a little bit too much, there's no real worry. The only thing you don't want to do is keep your fish in it too long, because this is actually also used as a way to euthanize fish, meaning it's a humane way to kill fish. Now to ensure that I'm dosing the proper amounts, I use some medicine syringes. These are common and pretty cheap. You could pick them up at almost any drugstore. To ensure that the fish is stressed out the least amount possible, I use tank water to fill up the container that I'm going to be sedating him in. The container I'm using is a 30-gallon clear tote. I put 10 gallons of water in it total. Now, on a side note about this video is I not only have to worry about the fish and focus on the task at hand, I'm also filming it with multiple cameras. Unfortunately, that's the downside to filming this, was I not only had to ensure that I was doing a proper job, but also had to make sure I wasn't ruining the shot by being in it. You could see what I was doing, the cameras were still rolling, they didn't run out of batteries or memory, and so forth. With 10 gallons of water in the container, I added an airstone, and this airstone is actually going to be used for two reasons. One, it's to mix the clove oil up well in the water. The clove oil is a very oily substance and has a tendency to collect on the surface of the water if the water is not continuously agitated. I'm also using the airstone to help deliver the water directly over the fish's gills to ensure that it's being medicated quickly. Now, just in case I didn't have enough clove oil, I also had an extra dose ready on standby that I could easily add to the water. The table that I'm filming this on is actually very rigid and rough. So I moistened up a towel the same temperature of the water. The towel would also double as something to calm the fish down in case it woke up too early. I would be able to place the towel over its head. To cut the fins, I just used some really basic scissors. Nothing fancy is needed here. You just want to make sure that they're sharp and sanitized. To net the fish, I used a big rubber net as I always do. This tends to get the fish out fastest, and he's not being chased around the tank. Once in the container, I covered the top of it with the net to make sure he can't jump back out. Eventually, he just calms down. Now, the sedative takes about 20 seconds to kick in. And like I said, I have a lot of other things to worry about, so I was off in the other room, shutting that camera off until I needed it to come back on. I didn't want to run out of battery. So at this point, I'm just monitoring the fish, waiting for him to go belly up. As soon as he goes belly up, it's only a few seconds after that that he'll be knocked out. Right now, he's getting dizzy and disorientated. Now, this doesn't mean he's knocked out, though. So what I like to do is flip the fish over and see if its muscles are flexing. At this point, he did tense up as if he was going to jump. So I wanted to make sure a couple more seconds in there until he stopped moving completely, almost like dead weight. I placed him on the towel and covered his head. Now, at this point, I'm extremely nervous. I really like this fish. I really care about this fish. And I know that I probably shouldn't be filming this because it's taking my attention off of the actual fish. So I'm nervous because I'm just worried I'm not going to do a good job, and I know, and I might hurt him. That's something I definitely didn't want to do. No matter how many times I do this, I'm always going to be nervous. I know exactly how much to dose, exactly the times. I know everything that's about to happen. But no matter how many times you do it, when you really care about this animal, you're going to be nervous. I trimmed the fins off close enough down to the stub of the tail that I felt comfortable that this would grow back properly. You definitely don't want to cut into the flesh of the fish. I decided at this point I would cut off not only the tail, but a little bit of his anal and dorsal fins, just so they would all grow back at the same time evenly. I then was looking at his scales and thinking, well, maybe I should remove a few of those because they are chipped. However, I quickly decided I'm going to give them a chance at growing back naturally. Again, gotta go put that camera on. This here was actually a bit of a mistake. His teeth got caught on the towel. Totally unconscious, though. Now back to the tank. The airstone is in there. Another airstone is in there to pass over his gills. I apologize that you can't directly see, but you will in a moment. In retrospect, I probably should have had somebody help me film this, but like all my videos, I do everything myself. So he's not responding to this immediately. And if you've never done this before, you're going to think it's hopeless and they're dead. There's nothing you can do. You just need to give him a few minutes. You'll notice that I keep letting him go to see if he'll swim off and to see if he'll go straight back up. He keeps going belly up though, so I know he's still unconscious. I keep the airstone over his head and passing fresh water over his gills, trying to kind of flush out that clove oil water. At this point, I guess I could say that no matter how many times you do this, the recovery process is always stressful. As you can see, it almost looks like he's a dead fish, but I'm leaving him alone for a moment and seeing how he's doing. Now he's starting to wake back up though. You can kind of see him flexing the muscles in his body and his sides, almost trying to swim off. But he's still not quite awake. I think he needs a little bit more help here, so I put him back under the airstone. This recovery process ended up taking a lot longer than I anticipated on doing so. But again, he keeps showing signs of recovery and he's getting better and better with it, so I know he's going to be okay. It's just going to take a bit of time. 10 minutes later, he's swimming around the tank like nothing had happened. He's still a little bit shaken, but he's going to be okay. Three months later, he's in his new aquarium, and his fins grew back beautifully. There are a few spots that didn't grow back perfectly, but I'm going to give it a little bit while longer and see how that turns out. For the most part though, I'm extremely happy with how this turned out. Most of his scales have now healed as well and started to grow back, even the chipped ones. I suspect within a few more months, he's gonna look amazing. That's been my video on how I performed a bit of cosmetic surgery to my Asian arowana. I hope you guys enjoyed it and potentially found it either interesting or even learned something from it. If you'd like to view the original video to this, I definitely invite you to do that as well. It was done on the same type of fish using the same method. Anyways guys, I hope that you enjoyed the video. I also wanted to thank you for watching and I'll see you guys next week for a new do-it-yourself project.